Dear friends, dear colleagues, dear CIO Minister Azoubalis, dear new Secretary General Ambassador Zanier, dear Director of ODIHR Ambassador Lenacek, dear Speaker of the Parliament, dear Prime Minister, we are all very proud to be here in Serbia in our 20th anniversary. And also we are proud to be in this building, in the Sava Center, that it was built in 1977 in order to host the first OSCE activities. And it is kind of the spirit of those days that inspires me today for a few words about our main topic, that is how to strengthen our organization, how to help our organization to be more efficient, more effective. So that means, what are the needed reforms of our organization? And I say that by understanding deeply in my life, in my heart, in my mind, the value of the solidarity because of the threat of my country, because of the dangers of my country, danger of my country. Because my country was at the edge of a disaster, and the will of the Greek people, the will of our parliament, but also the solidarity of our friends in Europe protected us from a failure. That's why I'm here in front of you, because I know in my heart, in my skin, what solidarity means, what cooperation means, why we need organization for security and for cooperation, as OSCE was made to be. And this is not for us as politicians, as the political class, but this for our people, that we are devoted to serve them, for the people, the everyday people, from Kyrgyzstan to Canada, and from Greece to Norwegian. That's why I would like to speak by my heart, because those are the days of decisions. Those are the days of decision because, to be very clear, very frank, we know that this organization, with this huge history that maybe changed the history of Europe, now is in crisis, is in an identity crisis. And we all know that. And we know that because we have recently the Astana summit. And compare in your mind, let's us compare in our minds, how was the 1999 summit in Istanbul? There were President Clinton, President Yeltsin, they signed the CFE treaty. And because of the CFE treaty, the most important military treaty, we have not the threat of a major war in Europe, because we destroyed 62 items of heavy military equipment in our countries. And compare Clinton and Yeltsin, sealing the future of Europe in peace, and compare the Astana summit, where Hillary Clinton was in the beginning present, and we have not the ability to continue with an action plan, but we reaffirmed the commitments that we have undertaken in the past. It is terrible to have the leaders of our 56 participating states to agree that we have had a very good past, but we cannot define the future. This is the crisis, this is the sense of the crisis, because each organization has its life. Life is the future, it's not the past. So this organization deserves to take some huge initiatives. And to be very, very concrete and very frank, we know that the world is changing. we have the international economic crisis. We know very well that our governments are not the main factors in economy. There are the famous markets. There are anonymous, but they are most powerful than our governments. We always hear, it's now 3 years, President Obama assured us that there will be some measures to have regulations that markets cannot make their own games without regulations, but we don't have regulation, international regulation. Chancellor Merkel also, she had some measures but to protect Germany. She said, if you don't have German bonds, you cannot have CDS on those bonds. I do not permit my country to be like to have a lotto, a joker, I don't know how we say this, games of, I don't know this part of the life, so forgive me, it's not only English, I don't know how you play these games. And of course, President Sarkozy assured all of us, Juncker, Olli Rehn, but until now, it's now 3 years, we don't have regulations. We speak between us as governments, and there is a silent third that maybe he has the ultimate power. That is a factor of instability for all of us in the world. So we need cooperation. We need organizations that provide cooperation and safety. And also we know that the balance of power is changing. We have the new powers, China, Brazil, India, the famous BRICS. We have this void of security if we believe that Europe is not only the Euro-Atlantic region, but if we believe that Europe is also the Eurasian region. So, we have new phenomena. We have many international players and many international organizations not even to refer to OEC. The NATO summit in November 2010 made this, for me, very, very dangerous form of decision, that we base everything in collaboration, in cooperation, but they didn't refer to OEC. There is no mention of OEC as partnership. And the whole decision of NATO is based on partnership. But OEC disappears from the partners. The EU the same, you know very well. And that's why we have to say between us, if OEC did not exist, we have had to invent him, to invent it. Because it's the only organization that can guarantee this concept of security of the Europe in the Euro-Atlantic and the Eurasian also region. And we have the pride to serve in this organization in which the concept of security is indivisible. It's not only political-military, it's not only economic, it's not only environmental, it's not only human rights and democratic regime and the rule of law, but it's the three of them indivisible. That is OEC. This is our pride. This is our task. This is our unique role and unique position. But in order to work and to achieve this sense of indivisible security in political military terms, in economic terms, in human rights, in democracy, in freedom of media, that means the dignity of men and women in each country, the freedom of the individual in a free society. We have to be together. Governments, the structure in Vienna, the structure in Warsaw, we have to be an organization. An organization means that it is complementary. We have to be like that. And we are not. We are not. I have to be very frank. As a president of this assembly is obliged to be. Frank, clear. And I sent that to Ambassador Zanier as the new Secretary General, and I hope to have with him the best collaboration, the best cooperation, in order to achieve the best for our organization. It was in Vienna that our leadership of Transparency and Accountability Committee heard 1 year ago that Parliamentary Assembly is not an institution of OSCE and nobody is obliged to have a meeting with the representatives of Parliamentary Assembly. This insane position is what diminishes our organization. The Parliamentary Assembly is an institution of OSCE and it's a genuine political body. We represent our people, we represent our ideologies, our political thesis, but first of all we represent the values of the organization because we represent the people of our societies. And we are part of the organization. So, if it is to have a future in this organization, we have to respect each other and be in touch, in communication, and to have a common field. And that's why we propose our three committees to be in touch on a regular basis with the three relevant committees in Vienna. The executive branch of the organization to be in cooperation with us as Parliamentary Assembly, not to be something strange or hostile to us. And we have to be together also in the space, in the field of election observation mission. We are complementary with ODIHR, but we need to have some rules to define our common task, and the rules are there. It's the letter and the spirit of the Copenhagen Agreement. In order to achieve the best, to be reliable to all the people in which we want to transfer our best practices and our credibility. And we need to have political initiatives by the CIOs. And political initiative means to respect that OSCE is a political organization, so the Parliamentary Assembly is the place where we have this free, real political dialogue between us. And we have resolutions that represent the political will of a free assembly. And we know that. We know that between us. We are not preoccupied. Nobody guides us except our conscience. So I think that we must have a new era for the organization. And the Parliamentary Assembly is ready to offer our expertise, our devotion to the principles of this organization and the deep knowledge of how delicate thing is democracy, how sensitive thing is to build in our societies the democratic life of everyday political life, of the life of our citizens. So we must be decisive. We must give to our organization the substance of an effective and efficient organization, and this requires communication, respect and collaboration in the field when the results will be not in the benefit of the CIO, of the General Secretary, of the Director of ODIHR, of the Parliamentary Assembly, but of the people of our 56 participating states. In we are their representatives. That's why we believe that we have and we can to contribute to the future of this organization. Thank you.